They can play it back. They can play for the conference championship, but we're the best in the conference. One on the field. Bells, I'm proud of you. I am so proud of you. Nobody, they don't believe somewhere else, but you believed right here. They can put you an underdog and you're seventh in the nation, but you believe. And then I'm proud of you because you don't need nobody else to believe as long as you believe. And you did. And that's a great job. Defense, great, great effort. Offense, way to put the points up. Great overall win, man. Great overall win. We're going to savor it all night long. And then on Sunday morning, it's Bama. You want to say something, man, real quick now?
Hey, fellas, like Coach just said, Sunday, that's where it all starts, baby. That is where it all starts, baby. We got to carry it from Sunday to Saturday, baby.
At a remote outpost in frozen South Korea, an Army sergeant tunes his radio to the Armed Forces Network to listen as he pulls guard duty along the DMZ. A Selma native living in Fairbanks, Alaska, is hosting a listening party today with his friends who'll hear the game via telephone, all decked out in orange and blue. A sellout crowd of 85,000 will watch in person, while 44,000 more, who scarfed up all the available tickets, will view a closed-circuit telecast in Tuscaloosa, making this the only game to sell out two stadiums at one time. It impacts the lives of just about everyone who lives here or ever has. If your team wins, seashells and balloons. But losing means a whole year of pure agony. It's the annual meeting between Auburn and Alabama. Hello again, everybody. War Eagle from Jordan-Hare Stadium.
In 1989, it was the first time ever. In 1993, it would be the crowning achievement for a team of destiny. For the next 3.5 hours, the state would come to a virtual standstill as the people of Alabama witnessed a true classic. Auburn versus Alabama. Victory at Jordan-Hare, part two.
Situation, the ball on the Auburn side of midfield at the 49. 6:44 left in the opening period, no score. White again will run from the shotgun. Alabama shows him a five-man front line. Here is White. He's going to throw out in the flat to Richardson. Richardson at midfield looking for a block. Sidesteps a tackle, spins away from another 45 to the 40. And Tony Richardson has a first down on a brilliant run. Down to the Alabama 36, a 15-yard gain. What a move by Richardson as he did a pirouette at the 40-yard line and sidestepped a would-be tackler and got about 5 or 6 more yards.
Tony Richardson with 25 receptions coming into this ball game, catches it in the right flat, makes one man miss, and then he picks up a tremendous block out on the flank by Frank Sanders to get the first down. So Auburn moving well on 3rd and 9. Auburn 40% in their success rate on third down conversions this year.
We're at 2nd and 8. No score in the ball game. 3:54 opening period. White's going to take it straight up the middle out of the shotgun to the 15. White's to the 11 and close to a first down. Stan White had him in the shotgun and a gaping hole opened up right up the middle and he raced for about 10 yards. Michael Rogers, Mario Morris making the stop. They'll give him about 8 yards on the play and Auburn is a yard away from a first down.
Boy, what a veteran play by Stan White. And that looked to be a called play, Jim. That looked to be a called play on the monitor here in the booth. The offensive guards for Auburn, Todd Bolin and Jason Taylor, took off downfield, and I think that was a planned quarterback draw.
Really worked well. White, let's give him 7 yards to the Bama 11, and here's 3rd down and 1, and White on the sneak is going to push the pile ahead inside the 10 and on to about the 7, and that'll be a first down. Stan White on the quarterback sneak, ducked in there behind Robeek, and the middle of the Auburn interior offensive line, led by Taylor and Bolin. And Auburn will be first and goal at Bama's 7-yard line. 23 yards. Well, the first one didn't count because Alabama had the penalty. Chip shot for Etheridge here. Well within his range. Not much of an angle. The ball pretty well in the middle of the hash marks. Carter puts it down. Kick is away. That kick is good. And Auburn Auburn has the lead on Alabama. Here's Auburn, first and 10 at the 20. White toss sweep to the tailback, Stephen Davis, 5 yards. Davis, 10 yards, breaking tackle, slamming out to the 35. Give him 15. On his first carry of the afternoon, the sophomore from South Carolina barrels ahead for 15 big yards. Willie Gaston, the last line of defense for Alabama, made the saving tackle for the Tide. Willie Gaucher, the wide receiver on the far flank. And here's Thomas Bailey on this near left side, or the short side of the field, the ball at the left hash mark. Alabama in a 3-4 defensive alignment. Out of the shotgun is White. Has time. Shoots a pass. Bailey grabs it for a first down at the 45-yard line. Thomas Bailey on a good catch as Tommy Johnson was with him, but he was able to get in there and somehow grab it away from Johnson for a 10-yard gain.
Stan White threaded the needle on that pass because Thomas Bailey did not have a lot of room in there. Tommy Johnson right on him coverage-wise. Chris Donnelly backing up. That was a curl route. Stan White threw it right between the two, and Thomas Bailey made a great catch, and Auburn got a good spot out of that and got the first down.
Got 8 yards. Here's Williams now in a tailback, and he's going to give on the end-around reverse to Kevin Lee in the open field. 40, 45, 50. Lee may go. He's at the 40, the 35, the 30, down this near sideline to the 25, to the 20, to the 10. He is gone. Touchdown, Alabama, 63 yards. They gave on the end-around reverse. Sherman Williams was the tailback, and he gave it to Lee coming back to this near side, and there was no catching Kevin Lee.
Well, we mentioned it in the Tiger Tailgate show that Kevin Lee has run 3 reverses this year, and he has averaged 33 yards on those reverses, had a 66-yarder against Tulane, and on that play, the Auburn defense was completely fooled. Calvin Jackson had one chance, but had a blocker on him. He did turn Kevin Lee back to the inside, but he broke back to the outside as Proctor adds the extra point for Alabama.
From the 24, Stan White. Richardson is now at fullback. Both ends are split from the eye set. Here's a play fake by Stan. He's going to set up, throw to this near boundary. He's got Bailey. He's got it at the 39. That's a completed pass. Diving toward the boundary, Thomas Bailey made sure he kept his feet inbounds, and that's a 15-yard gain and a first down.
A long sideline, and that is a very difficult throw back to his left side, and Stan White put a lot of velocity on that ball, and Thomas Bailey did a remarkable job of getting 1 foot down in bounds, the official right on top of it. A nice play and a beautiful pass by Stan White.
Williams the tailback. Both ends are split. Barker trying to change his play at the line of scrimmage. Can they hear him? No. They break out of the eye. Barker again to throw from the end zone. He's in trouble. Barker goes down. That's an Auburn safety. He was hit from behind by Jason Miska. Auburn has recorded a safety, tackling Alabama's Jay Barker in the end zone. Jason Miska, the Auburn linebacker. The sophomore from Bridgeport, Connecticut, walk-on player, hit Barker from behind. Barker trying to throw out of the end zone for a second straight play. That time, they made him pay.
5.5 minutes left in the opening half. Auburn trails 7-5 and needing about 6 yards from their 45-yard line. Slot to the right, White from the shotgun. Keeps McMillan in as a blocker. There's a snap to White. He's in trouble. Dodges the rush. White races across the 50. Got a first down to the Alabama 48. Well done by White. Alabama had the blitz on from Will Brown, and Stan sidestepped him and darted for about 8 or 9 yards.
Alabama coming with a lot of people, especially Sam Shade, the strong safety who lined up in the middle of the field as a middle linebacker. He came straight up the center gap, and that's exactly who Stan White sidestepped, their leading tackler, Sam Shade, and that is a heady play by a veteran quarterback to be able to pick up that first down.
From the eye. Toss sweep, tailback. Anderson got some room, 15. He's going to go to the 10 to the 5. Touchdown, Alabama. Anderson, 19 yards for the score. Nobody laid a hand on Chris Anderson as he got outside and turned that corner.
Brian Robinson from the free safety position made a charge and turned Chris Anderson in early, but then Chris Anderson, who has found a lot of running room in this first half, on the Auburn flanks with the tall sweep, went almost untouched into the end zone.
13-5. Move the ball back to the Alabama 45 at 2nd and 13 from there. Barker's going to the air, flushed out of the pocket, sacked. Back to the Bama 35. Loss of 10 yards. Pelton and Harris closed him out. Big loss on the play as Jay Barker, who was sacked in the Bama end zone in the first half for a safety, is sacked this time
by a great pass rush by Auburn.
Great pass rush that time inside by Mike Pelton and outside by Willie Whitehead. They double-teamed Jay Barker, who looked like he had some time to throw the football, couldn't find an open receiver, and retreated back to his left, and a big loss for Alabama.
Alabama's going to go trips to the right with one setback, Tarrant Lentz, the fullback. Three wide receivers on this near right side for Barker. Third down and very long. The pump fake by Barker, and they sack him again. This time it's Anthony Harris on a delayed blitz, dropping Jay Barker back inside the Alabama 30, where it'll be fourth down and a half a mile.
And Auburn's defense did what they needed to do. They took that penalty play that stopped Alabama and gave them a long yardage situation and put the Alabama offense in a predictable situation.
Deal on fourth and 29 will punt it away, and there's another cannon shot, but this one is a low line drive that Bailey will field at his 26 and pick up a block. 35, he's at the 40, he's at midfield. Deal grabs him from behind and yanks him down at the Alabama 45. Ryan Deal, the Bama punter. A 25-yard return by Thomas Bailey, and Auburn's in good shape. First and 10 in Bama land.
And if Brian Deal doesn't make the tackle, he was the punter. If he doesn't make the tackle, that's a touchdown for Auburn. Thomas Bailey found that seam. He caught all of his blockers. There was a wall here on the left side, and he cut through the wall, and it was clear sailing. But Brian Deal made a nice tackle. Alabama second down and 7.
Wideouts left and right. Toss sweep to the tailback. Williams racing to this near side, and he's knocked out of bounds. Losing yardage on the play. A solid leak by Chris Schilling. Bumped him out of bounds. Back along the 15. Third and 6. White rolling to his left. Pump faking. Got some room. Going to carry it over the 30. The 35. Spinning away from tackle to the 40. Great move by Stan White up to the 41-yard line for a first down. Romanski Hall finally made the tackle, but White showing great second and third effort after he was hit along the 30. He was hit again at the 35, spun away and got about 5 more yards in a first and 10.
Great job by Stan White of pulling it down and getting that first down. The quarterback, when he has his receivers covered, it's left up to the quarterback to find a way to get that first down, make a good play out of a bad play, and that's what Stan White did on that one.
Here's White needing 6 for a first down. Stan up under center this time, out of the eyes, going to give it to Reed McMillan, the fullback, and he stumbles across the 50 and falls into the Alabama 45. Jeremy Nunley tripped him up, but Reed McMillan had a big hole, big gap to run through, and he's got another Auburn first down.
Reed McMillan broke the tackle of Jeremy Nunley, and he broke it enough to get the first down. Good forward momentum. Anytime a fullback is tackled, he likes to be tackled going toward the goal line, and that's what happened with Reed McMillan. Nice run up the middle.
They say his knee on the ground at the Bama 46. Here's Bostic back in at the tailback. Richardson replacing McMillan at fullback. A play fake to Bostic by White. Rolling to his right, setting up and firing. Pass is caught by Sanders down at the Alabama 30-yard line. Another first down, a gain of 14 yards. Stan White zipping that one to his split receiver, Frank Sanders, out in the right flat.
After a play action fake, and Willie Anderson doing a good job on Andre Royal, not letting Andre Royal, who's been in the Auburn backfield all day, bother Stan White on the pass. Stan stood in there, stepped forward, and fired on the curl route in front of Antonio Langham to Frank Sanders. That's a nice catch and gain. First down Auburn on the Alabama 30.
Stan White waiting for the snap. He's got it. Alabama's bringing everybody. They hit him. He's going down. Drew in desperation. Pass is incomplete. Could have been intercepted. Jeremy Nunley had hold of White, as did a couple of other Crimson Tide defenders. And White, I believe, is hurt on the play. Yes, he is. Stan White shaken up on the play. They had him twisted around and pulled him down from behind just as he was throwing the football. It fell to the ground, but it could have been intercepted. And as they look after Stan White, a time is called with 6:22 left in the third period. How costly would that be? A hush has fallen over the crowd as Stan White is being looked after by the Auburn trainers. They are helping him to his feet. We may not see Stan White again today. He is going to be helped to the sidelines, and Patrick Nix will be called on to quarterback Auburn, probably for the remainder of the game. White unable to put any weight at all on that left foot. Nix, 6'2", 188, redshirt sophomore out of Rainbow City. And you talk about pressure. White ruled down on the play, losing 4 yards, so it's fourth down and 14 to go. Nix this time will go for it with 6:22 left in the third period. Auburn trailing 14-5. Out of shotgun, Patrick Nix. Alabama bringing everybody. Nix is going to float one for Sanders. Sanders, oh, he caught it at the two, and he dived in. Touchdown, Auburn! Touchdown, Auburn! Oh, my goodness! Sanders went up over Tommy Johnson or Antonio Langham. He caught the ball at the two. How he held it, I don't know, but he dived into the end zone, and Auburn's right back at the thick of it with a backup quarterback. 14-11, a 39-yard pass play, Patrick Nix to Frank Sanders.
Well, you can't get more predictable than 4th and 16, and all the Alabama defensive coaches knew exactly what Auburn needed to do. They were going to put the ball up in the air. Patrick Nix lofted a gorgeous pass down this near sideline, and Frank Sanders, who's been Auburn's big play man all year long, does it again over Tommy Johnson.
Etheridge kicks, point after, good. It's a brand new game. Alabama 14, Auburn 12, 6:09 left in the third period. Nix throwing for a touchdown on his first snap of the game in relief of Stan White. Has a 2nd and 6 situation at his 44. Nix is going to toss sweep to his tailback. Bostic cuts it back inside. 50, Bama 45, he's at the 40, he's at the 35, he's to the 32-yard line. Antonio Langham, the last man who had a chance, grabbed his ankle. That's a gain of 24 yards and a first down. And Auburn is cooking now.
And that's the momentum that the Auburn offensive line can provide this Auburn team, because Auburn's defense is certainly playing a much better and sounder game here in the second half. Auburn's offensive line has got to step it up, and it appears that they're doing just that.
Steven Davis now has replaced Bostic at tailback. Auburn with the ball at the Bama 33. Richardson's at fullback. Both ends are split. The fake by Nix. He's rolling right. He's throwing on the run. Sanders pulls it in at the Bama 25-yard line and is ridden out of bounds at about the 26 by Langham. Patrick Nix and the Auburn offense needing a yard and a half for a first down at the Alabama 24. 2 minutes, 19 seconds, third period. Alabama 14, Auburn 12. Here we go. Nix up under center, running from the eye. The tailback is Bostic. One wide receiver, two tight ends. Give up the middle. McMillan, the fullback, has his first down as he slithers into the 20. Reed McMillan just burrowed into the pile and squirmed into about the 20-yard line.
Good job by Shannon Robeek, and an outstanding job by Jason Taylor, the right guard. Jason Taylor completely dominated his man at the point of attack and allowed that running crease for Reed McMillan to get the first down. Auburn set up now on the Alabama 21, lead with a 2-point lead, 14-12.
John Carter, Frank Sanders, the wideouts in a slot formation left. Stan White on the bench, setting this one out after the twisted knee. Patrick Nix out of Rainbow City, the redshirt sophomore, is going to toss sweep. There's Bostic looking to get outside. He does, turning the corner. 15, 10, 9, 8-yard line. Johnson and Gaston on the tackle of James Bostic. 13 yards and another first down. Etheridge had a field goal in the first half. This will be 26 yards out of the hold of Sean Carter. The ball at the left hash mark. Etheridge having to shield his eyes from the sun. Sets up, waiting for the snap from Brinsfield. There's the snap, the spot, the kick is away. This kick is good. And Auburn leads 15-14. Barker will go with split backs, Lynch and Anderson. Wideouts left and right. They need 2 yards on third down, and Barker's got time. Going to throw long down the middle of the field. This one's intercepted. Robinson, 40, 45, 50, 45 to the Alabama 43. Flags are down. Flag went down after the tackle was made. A fight appeared to break out, a shoving match between the two sides as Barker pump faked and was throwing down the middle of the field.
He was looking for Todrick Malone, Jim, down the middle of the field. And Auburn's going to get hit with the personal foul. But Brian Robinson was able to intercept that ball because he was behind Todrick Malone.
Williams is lifted from the Alabama backfield on this fourth down and a half-a-yard play. And they'll go with a pair of fullbacks, Lynch and Turner, and two tight ends. Barker's going to give it to Lynch up and over. Did not make it. He didn't make it. They stopped him a yard short. They stopped him. They stopped him. Auburn's got it. Folks, Auburn's got the ball at the Alabama 29. Who was it? Miska and Whitehead. Miska and Whitehead went under, and Lynch tried to hurdle him, and he couldn't get over.
Barker reversed out, gave the ball to Tarrant Lynch over right guard, and a host of Auburn players, everybody in there, eight or nine of the Auburn 11 defenders in there.
Pat Nix running from the shotgun, clock running at 8:14. Out of the shotgun, he's got time, and he floats one over the middle to Richardson. Sidesteps one man, 25. Richardson pulls in to the Alabama 20. Derek Dorn, the tight end. Both ends are split away. High formation. Reed McMillan is the fullback. It's going to be the tailback. Bostic, a hole, 15-10. Bostic, the 5. Bostic dragging tacklers with him to the 2-yard line. Gaston, the last man who had a shot at him, finally was able to wrestle him down at the Alabama 2.5.
I think Quentin Riggins made a nice point a moment ago when he talked about how the Auburn offensive line has an Alabama defensive line on the field. It's been on the field a long time today. They're a little bit tired.
Slide angle back to the left for Scott. Sean Carter's the holder. Kneeling at the 9. The snap. Dropped it. Carter racing to the outside. Carter running, looking. Will he score? No, he's down at the 1. Running to the wide side of the field was Sean Carter. As the snap was bobbled, he got up and raced to that wide side. Alabama was able to stop him. Nose end at the goal line. Lemanski Hall made the tackle. Sean Carter, a wide receiver by trade and one of the best holders in the business, was racing to get outside and turn that corner. Alabama had hold of him, and they were dragging him down. He was trying to back up into the end zone, but they got him down literally at the goal line. I'm talking the ball was nose end at the goal line, and Alabama will take over there. Fourth down play for Alabama, needing 10 yards from their 36 with 2:39 to play. If Auburn can hold him here, you've got to like the Tigers' chances. Jay Barker with all the noise in the world. Motion by Chris Anderson to the short side of the field, slot formation to the left. Barker to throw. Barker's going long for Todrick Malone. Ball is intercepted down at the Auburn 30-yard line. It was Del McGee. Del McGee on the interception. Alabama throwing the pass interception. Auburn's got the football. 15-14, they lead with 2:32 to go.
Jay Barker threw two interceptions against Auburn last year, and he's thrown his second interception against Auburn today. What an amazing turnaround by Del McGee, because Todrick Malone had outside position on him, and Del McGee was right there with Todrick Malone, but he didn't see the ball. Del McGee never saw the ball until he turned around right at the last instant, and it happened to be right there on his shoulder pads. Made a brilliant catch. Number 24, Del McGee, coming through with the interception.
2.5 minutes to play. Actually, 2:32 to go on a first down play. Here up the middle, Bostic, 5 yards, 10 yards, 45, Bostic, 50, Bostic, racing to the 45, to the 40, breaking a tackle to the 30, to the 20, to the 10, he's gone, touchdown, Auburn!
Well, I guess that lets you know that the Alabama defense, Jim, was a little bit tired. Boy, did James Bostic ever break that one. He had 3 touchdowns against Georgia. Coming in this week as the SEC Player of the Week offensively, 183 yards in that game, and that big man just broke it over the right side and outran everybody and broke another tackle around the 25-yard line. Great speed, great power. What a blocking by the Auburn offensive line.
70 yards. Auburn 21, Alabama 14 with 2:19 to play. Etheridge with Carter holding.
This is an important extra point. It would give Auburn an 8-point cushion.
The snap, spot, kick. Good! Auburn 22, Alabama 14 with 2:19 to go. Second and 10 at the Bama 27. That same formation, the pro set. Barker to throw. Barker hit. Barker's going down. A sack back at the 26. Willie Whitehead, Anthony Harris shedding blockers and dropping him for a yard loss to the 26-yard line. Third down and 11 now at the Bama 26, and the clock is moving at 1:45 to go. Freshman Marcel West, a speedy wideout, is in now on this left flank as Barker on the first down play is going to throw. He is hit just as he got it away, and he is down. Barker was hit very hard, and he is shaken up on the play. Damon Primus unloaded on Jay Barker.
Jim, Jay Barker's left knee is injured, and I mean That is not a good-looking injury. It's a serious injury to Jay Barker, unfortunately.
Writhing in pain.
Both quarterbacks now. Stan White suffering an injury to his left knee. And now Jay Barker with a minute, 24 seconds remaining in the fourth quarter. Alabama trailing Auburn 22-14. Barker being sacked while he's trying to throw the ball, injures his left knee.
And what a marvelous comeback by this Auburn team in the second half. Auburn was down and appeared to be out at halftime, trailing 14-5. Their offense could muster nothing. But they have come storming back, and they've taken the lead away from Alabama and dominated second half play. Second and 15 at Alabama's 35. A minute 18 to play for Bergdorf. Bergdorf chased out of the pocket. They sack him back at the 30-yard line. It was Walker and Harris who got Ryan Bergdorf going down for a loss of about 4.5 yards. It'll be third down and the better part of 20 to go. Alabama calling time with a minute 5 to play. Both starting quarterbacks have been sidelined in this game. It's been that hard hitting. Bergdorf on a 2nd and 10 play. Call it the Auburn 42. One running back out of the double wing. Bergdorf is being chased and pulled down. Sacked by Jason Miska. Back at the 47, 48-yard line. Miska reached out and clotheslined Bergdorf as he came by. 35 seconds. The clock is stopped with the Alabama timeout. They'll look at a 3rd and long. And Alabama will be 4th down and 18 with 29 seconds on the clock, arrested with the pass incompletion.
We'll probably see Alabama go into the 3 wideout situation and possibly just throw the ball up, hoping somebody is going to get it. No, they're coming out in a regular formation. They're going to actually go for the 18-yard gain here.
On the Auburn 49, Bergdorf checking out. Crowd on its feet, making all the noise it can, and Bergdorf's going to go down this near side again. This one is tipped away, incomplete. On 4th and 18, that'll do it. Malone, the intended receiver, coverage by Calvin Jackson again, and you can let the celebrating start. 21 seconds to go. All Auburn has to do is snap the football as we go down to Quentin Riggins. Q-Man, what do you got, baby?
Jim, it's wild down here. The fans are screaming crazy. On that last defense series, Wayne Hall knew that Alabama's offensive coordinator was going to go to the deuce. So what they did, they moved the linebackers, inside linebackers, out the middle and put them on the deuce just to bang them, to knock them out so he couldn't throw to them. So he had to go to an alternate receiver.
And what an unbelievable job of coverage on the last two attempts. Brian Bergdorf going deep down the left sideline. Both plays against Calvin Jackson. Calvin Jackson almost intercepts one, and then he knocks the other one to Todrick Malone away. He is a great cover man for Auburn.
Nick's taking the snap and falling to the ground, and this one's over, folks. Clock is running down. The final seconds. Let's let the crowd count them down for us.
For the Auburn Tigers since 1957 and the national championship year, and Auburn's national championship hopes are still alive.
I won't be but a second, man, and it's not gonna be emotional. It is an emotional day, and it should be for you from a standpoint of being excited about the events of today. But I wanted to come by the dressing room, win, lose, or draw, I was gonna be here to thank Terry and his staff and all of the people, Dr. Muse, administrators, everybody, for making me feel a part of this football team. Now, you can't imagine how important that's been to me. The players, same thing. Just, I mean, our relationship, and it's just been made my life a joyous one this fall, and watching you play, watching you grow, and being able to pull for you, and knowing the kind of quality and the character that we had in this program. Now, some of you may not like for me to say this, but I'm gonna say that we did not leave great ability three or four deep in every position. We got enough ability and we got quality ability. But what I left in this program was some men that had the qualities to go 11-0. All right, now let me tell you, that may not seem so significant to you, but I've been in football 40 years. Today, this year would have been my 41st as a player, coach, and everything. I'd been a part of an undefeated season one time prior to this and won championships on every level. This football team in here, if there's ever been a true champion, you have stood the test, paid the price, done everything that you can do when you got an O at the end of it, men. That's all you can ask. And you've done it in style and you've done it in class. And I congratulate you. And I ain't got to tell you what you mean to me. And hey, Terry, I deeply appreciate you and all the coaches. Coaches of my coaches that I left here, that's your coaches now, and former players, and your coaching staff that you brought with me has just been unbelievable as far as, again, making me feel welcome and making me feel a part of this football team. And I shall enjoy this cigar. Let me say this. None of you has had as much fun as I have today, because I started this morning early and I've been from one end of this campus to the other. And I will tell you something, you can't believe what has gone on in this town in the last 24 hours. Hey, you enjoy it tonight. And I know you're gonna handle yourself with class, just like y'all do.
Men, let's say one thing. Let's say one thing before we bow. Listen, men. Today, and I don't have to tell you, but today, you have set the standard. The greatest football team ever to play at Auburn University, 11-0, because of what you did on the field, 11-0. It's never been done before. There's better teams, maybe. There can be better, but you have done something nobody else can do, and no one will ever take it. You'll be the benchmark that they look to. And then one more thing. Absolutely. Today, I became an Auburn man. I can't believe it took so long. Let's bow for a word of prayer. Let's bow.
Okay, buddy.
Oh, God, we just give you thanks. We give you thanks for all you have done for us to give us the relationships, the love between each other, the wisdom that you had to give us the leadership that you've given us, for giving us the opportunity to come to Auburn and to know each other and to take us as low as you could take us, just so you could bring us to our highest point. We thank you for all your blessings. Take Alabama home safely. Heal their injured. Be with their spirit. Any glory we receive, let it be in your name. In Christ's name, amen.
Amen.
We love you, man.
Many times I've heard you say, I have to be ready. I have to be ready. I have to stay in the game.
It's unreal. You know, I thought about it all week, and, you know, I do every week. I get those gut feelings that this is the week, and, you know, I prayed about it all week, and just, you know, I just wanted to do my job, and I wanted to be the part, whatever part I had to play, whether it be, you know, signal the plays in, just look at the defenses, tell Stan what's going on, you know, I just wanted to do whatever I could do.
I hate to end my season like that, but there's no greater win than I've ever been associated with. Patrick did a great job coming in and keeping his poised, and the offense got it going, you know, started moving the ball. You know, I've just never been associated with a win so big, and heck, my knees kill me right now, but it doesn't feel near as good as the way I'm feeling, you know.
Tony and I, you know, said, you know, if we don't do it, we're going to lose.
We had to do it. We're the team. Is
somebody on fire here?
I think it's Harold.
What turned it around? What turned it around, Damon?
We just believed in ourselves and came out in the second half, played hard, played together, and we pulled it out.
Ain't nobody take this away from us. It's the best year it's made 5 years. It's beautiful. I love it.
When my grandchildren are on my knee and I'm sitting there sucking on Werther's Originals, I can sit there and tell them about the great day that we beat Alabama and went at 11-0.
We gave them, you know, two touchdowns this year, guy, but still, they didn't come away with the W, though. It's ours. And Auburn is back.
But Patrick came in, did a great job as far as coming in and take over. I can't take anything with Patrick. He's a great quarterback. He's going to lead them to a lot of more success in the future. He did what he had to do. He came in. That's what we've been doing all season. People have been stepping up and, you know, doing what he had to do. He did his part. So, hey, we're 11-0. We're champions.
To go out when everything's against you, and the only people who believe is your teammates and your coaches and a few select fans, and to win 11 games, I don't even know the word. I mean, I don't know Webster that good to tell you.
I thought he was going to punt. But Patrick came against the hole. It was 4th and 15. Then Patrick said, well, he just said, 278, Z takeoff. And I was like, what? I thought we were going to punt, but, you know what I mean? I guess it's just something to come in with confidence boosters. Coach Bowden did a great job of calling. I mean, you know, he stepped it up when he had to.
And Antonio didn't go to your side that time.
Nope. Coach Bowden had read it that Tommy Bowden had read that he was playing me just to the field and wasn't playing me to the boundary. And he kind of had tricked him up with that play. And I guess I was on gas to him. There wasn't no haps.
Stan being hurt, Patrick had to come in and step up. And like I said, he hadn't been playing that much season, though. But everybody knew we had confidence in him. And like I said, he came in, threw a touchdown, and got his team started. And Coach said in the locker room before we went back out that we went out to run the ball. And like I said, we just geared down and got with the running game, and like I said, it was working for us.